The state government is vowing to crack down on freight drivers after recent COVID outbreaks connected to infected truckies. It comes as Queensland records one new case of the virus linked to the Sunnybank cluster.
Ramming your way through a concrete barricade on a narrow dirt road probably isn't the smartest way to get into Queensland. Still, it didn't stop an angry New South Wales truckie from trying.
A truck driver, having been refused entry into Gundawindi the day before, and decided to drive their prime mover through our barriers, causing damage. So that person's been charged with unlawfully entering Queensland against the chose directions and also willful damage, and will appear in court at a later date.
They're loaded up with cargo, crates, and some of them COVID.
The biggest group coming across our borders are our freight drivers.
Truck drivers have sparked the majority of recent outbreaks here in Queensland. The Health and Transport Minister today held urgent talks to try to figure out how to let the truckies in, but not the virus.
We are concerned that these drivers, when they are coming back home or where they're travelling around, they're going to shopping centres, they're going to people's homes, they're going to other places that are risking transmission.
The government is looking at tightening protocols, including quarantine and limiting their movements.
The vast majority of truck drivers, when we've caught up with them because they've tested positive, have actually had the first dose.
Well, this weekend, the government hopes is a super one, for vaccines at least.
This is our chance. We are starting to get that big ramp up in vaccine supply that we've been promised for many months now.
All 38 community hubs will be open for walk-ins, as well as pop-ups at NRL games, including Mackay. Anyone over the age of 12 is welcome, and both Pfizer and AstraZeneca will be on offer.
It's about time everyone gets the choice of different vaccines that are available to them, and that's what this weekend's about.
It comes as Queensland records one new case of COVID. It was detected in home quarantine and is linked to the Sunnybank cluster. New South Wales, though, has had another disastrous day. There have been almost 1,300 cases and 12 deaths. Three of those were fully vaccinated and two were women in their 20s. Both of those had underlying health conditions. While there is some good news for returning Australians overseas, New South Wales will trial home quarantine. At the end of the month, 175 fully vaccinated people, including Qantas staff, will be able to quarantine at home for 7 days.
This is a really critical step to be able to build and operationalise a home-based quarantine system, so ultimately we can phase out, for the majority of people, hotel quarantine.
In Victoria, there's been 510 cases and one death. It's now at its 70% first dose vaccination target, meaning a slight easing of some restrictions. Amanda Hart for 10 News First.